swing high, swing low. Whether you're calling, wherever you go, I've been here before. 'Cause I think I'm falling just like a stone. Yeah, I knew that when I saw you for the first time. Time froze, didn't make a sound, like the universe split right in two. And you looked at me, and I looked at you. A hurricane picked me off the ground. Tried to say, wouldn't leave my mouth. Heard the truth, clear and loud, just ringing out. And I saw you for the first time. First time.
Oh my goodness. All I can see is all these little girls that were running around when they were 12 years old. You're all absolutely gorgeous. Don't cry. You're so beautiful. Kick after your father. Oh, look at you. It's absolutely gorgeous.
You're
excellent.
Thank you.
You are. What's that trust? $129?
Huh? I got it on sale.
You guys look amazing.
I have no chance to update.
I don't want to break anything. My beautiful girl.
Thank you. Now, friends, let us pray. O God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should become one, join, we pray, in a bond of inseparable love these your loving servants who are about to be united today in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love more fruitful, they may become, by your grace, witnesses to charity itself. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. I invite you all, please, to be seated for our scripture reading.
A reading from the book of Tobit. On their wedding night, Tobiah arose from bed and said to his wife, "Sister, get up. Let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and to grant us deliverance." Sarah got up, and they started to pray and beg that deliverance might be theirs. They began with these words, "Blessed are you, O God of our fathers. Praised be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creation praise you forever. You made Adam, and you gave him his wife Eve to be help and support. And from these two, the human race descended. You said, 'It is not good for man to be alone. Let us make him a partner like himself.' Now, Lord, you know that I take this wife of mine not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and on her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age." They said together, "Amen, amen." The word of the Lord.
Amen. us to number our days aright, that we gain wisdom of heart, and have pity on us. Return, O Lord, fill us with your love, O Lord, and we will sing for joy. And we will sing for joy.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent us Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. The word of the Lord.
My friends, the Lord be with you. Thank you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, Lord. Jesus said to those who are listening, from the beginning of creation, I tell you this, God made them male and female. And for this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but they are one flesh. This is the point that matters. But before we go on any further, I just ask you a favor. Those of you who will be going to the reception this evening, which is at the Admiral Room. That's hot. That's where I was going. Yeah. If you're going to the reception, do me one big favor. Get Renee drunk as fast as you can, okay? Just get her, just please, okay? Okay. She need to calm down. This is the moment. I'm just meeting mom and dad of the bride for the first time. Do you know how many people are here for you two? Honest to God, that's a lot of gifts. All right, that's what matters. Mike's going. But we need excitement in our lives. We need happiness. We need joy. We're all tense. We're all ready to pounce. We're at red lights, and you know how life is now. It's not what it used to be. So an occasion like this, a big occasion, it requires excitement and planning. So all we can do is love her for getting on our nerves for the last 9 months. No. This is a day, all the planning's done, everything's done. The bridal party looks sharper than sharp. You have four of the finest musicians in Western New York in this year. Wait, just wait. You'll thank me later. But it's your day. It's their day, and they're not even paying attention to what I'm saying, which is typical for a bride and groom. No, that's fine. They're still talking. I'll wait. I have power, you know. I have power. We love you. We're happy for you. We're excited for you. We're hope-filled for you. We know it's going to work because you do have parents and family members and friends who love you. We love you so much. So we're with you. And we bless you as you begin your marriage together. And friends, since there's so many of you, and since I cut 2/3 of my homily out, could we just tell them one more time how much we love them? Andrea and Micheal, have you come here freely today, without coercion, and wholeheartedly to enter into the sacrament of marriage? Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared, if it's God's will, to accept children lovingly from him and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since that is your intention, I ask you to please now declare your consent before God and his church.
Take you, Andrea.
To be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. To love you and to honor you. All the days of my life. I, Andrea.
Take you, Micheal.
To be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. To love you and to honor you. All the days of my life. My friends, may the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have just declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God has joined together today, let no man separate. Hey, buddy, you're up. May the Lord bless these rings now, which you're about to give to one another as a sign of your faith and your deep, abiding, unending love.
Andrea, take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mike, take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Okay.
Friends, it is now official and legal in the eyes of the church to make it binding, official, and legal for the state of New York. We ask our witnesses who are signing the license to please come forward now and do so.
What?
Then sign it. Thank you. Okay, buddy, print your name there and then sign it underneath. Thank you.
We ask you to bless Andrea and Micheal on their journey through life, and to grant them all the graces necessary to fulfill the promises they have made to each other here today.
For all the married couples here today, may today be a reminder of the joy of their special day. May they give thanks for the happiness that they have known, and may each day find them more and more devoted to each other. Let us pray to the Lord.
Ventris.
5 of the finest musicians in Western New York. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Friends, I'd like to invite you to please kneel or be seated.
When we eat this bread
and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, 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 amen. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created us in your own image, and willed that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these your servants who are today joined in the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, O Lord, come down upon this bride, Andrea, and upon Michael, her companion for life. May the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may adorn their family with children and enrich the entire church.
Darci che
when stars go eterna stella sei. Nella mia preghiera,
let this be our prayer.
Quanta fede c'è.
My friends, may God, the all-powerful Father, grant you his joy and bless you and your children. May the only begotten Son of God stand by you always with compassion in good times and in bad. And may the Holy Spirit of God always pour forth his love into your hearts. And may Almighty God bless each and every one of us here today in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Michael McDonald.
Higher and higher, I said you're love. always around me. Only love, only love. Darling, I feel you under my body. Only love, only love. Give me shelter, oh show me heart. Come on love, come on love. Watch me fall apart, watch me fall apart.
Surrounded by a million people, I still feel all alone. Just wanna go home. Oh, I miss you, you know. And I've been keeping all the letters. letters that I wrote to you, each one a line or two. I'm fine, baby, how are you? Well, I would send them, but I know that it's just not enough. My words were cold and flat, and you deserve more than that. Another aeroplane, another sunny place. I'm lucky, I know, but I wanna go home. I got to go home. Let me go home. Just too far from where you are. I wanna come home. And I feel just like I'm living someone else's life. It's like I just stepped outside when everything was going right. And I know just why you could not come along with me. This was not your dream, but you always believed in me. Another winter day has come and gone away. Paris, Rome, and I wanna go home. Let me go home. And I'm surrounded by a million people. I still feel alone. Let me go home. Oh, I miss you, you know. Let me go home. Home. Let me go home. It'll all be all right.
Let's hear it for them, ladies and gentlemen, their first dance tonight.
I'm coming back.
Absolutely flawless.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here tonight. For all those of you who don't know me, my name is Joe McDonald. I'm the best man and Mike's brother. The year is back in 1992, and the whole house was to myself. It was just me. I was the king of the house. I had everything. I had nothing but my toys, my parents, but I was missing something. I was missing my best friend. My best friend was Mike. Sure enough, the year 1994 came, and my best friend came. And we did everything together. We did everything together between all of our best friends. Myself, my best friends, his best friends, we played street hockey together. Airsoft, everything you can imagine. We did it all together. One day, Christmas 2003 came along, and my brother received a computer and a copy of Microsoft Flight Simulator 2003. That all changed because his friends and my friends, we would always get together and we would play airplane together. He would be the pilot. Our friends would sit behind him as passengers, right in his room. It would be daily after school. So, but then I noticed a suspicious passion in my brother. I always knew he wanted to be a pilot. I found out that he continued this passion when we were down in Florida at my grandparents' house in Bradenton. Between fishing in the lake, and swimming in the pool, we would
always, every single year, get a foam airplane from our grandparents. We would throw that around the lake. Sometimes we would get it trapped in the lake, and we would have to convince my grandpa to get the net out of the lake, or get the net out of the pool, fish out of the lake, and we just continue until the sun went down. So we would do this continuously, and then summer came around. We'd have continuous friendships between us, friends at St. Mark's, and then summer would come around, and we would have friendships up in Crystal Beach, Canada. And here, everyone, we were a pact that couldn't be broken, and our friendships couldn't be, were intertwined, without saying it. As our friendships grew in Crystal Beach, we'd go from digging up sandcastles, hanging out at the beach. Then we grew older, and yes, Dad, I'm sorry, but we, many times me and Mike would sneak into the back shed and steal beers out of the back shed. But then there came a time where we were having fires in the backyard. Walking down the street were two girls, Andrea and Julia, going down to Julia Kohler's to hang out, and Mike would always say to me, "Hey, who's that?" I was like, "Oh, that's Julia and Julia and Andrea." I'm like, "Oh." And always look her way. And I knew from there, I'm like, well, our friendship is gonna grow even further. So then finally I met Andrea. I was hanging out with Katie in her cottage, and I met Andrea and Julia. Julia, I knew, was the feisty one, because the first time I met Julia, she thought it was funny to throw a banana at me and laugh. I said, "Who is this crazy one? She's crazy as me." But I saw something in Andrea as well. I saw that caring compassion that I saw in my brother. My brother wanted to be a pilot, and Andrea had that compassion and drive to be, to help others. I knew she wanted to be a nurse and somebody who would be there regardless of anything else and put herself aside for other people. I knew Andrea was the perfect one for my brother, that perfect person. Before I went away to training for the Secret Service, I was over at Mike's apartment, and they both said to me, well, Mikey said to me, "We are dating now." I went away relieved. I was so nervous about going away, leaving my home, knowing that my brother was going to be okay, knowing that Mike was in good hands and he was with his best friend, our best friend. Everybody at this table that we grew as friendship with each other became family. We left, well, I left for training. Mike went away for the Air Force, and we always FaceTimed each other, talking about our antics, what's going on back home. And I knew that Mikey was gonna be okay because he was with his best friend. So it would bring a sense of calm to me. It would, knowing that Mikey was with our best friend from Crystal Beach. So in summary, you know, summarizing up, everybody here at this table, best friends, we love each other for the rest of our lives. So I want to raise a toast. Mike and Andrea, tonight, you taxi out to the runway of happiness. Pilot and co-pilot, all of us here sitting, are sitting first class as you fly off into the sunset of happiness for the rest of your lives. Cheers.
Nice job, Joe. I met Andrea around 15 years ago in Crystal Beach, Canada. Our cottages were right down the street from each other. From first meeting, I knew that we would become best friends. As years went on, and we became closer, we'd not only hang out in Canada over the summer, but also in Buffalo over the winter and have made countless memories together. When we first became friends, we found out our first similarity was how we both would leave our life behind in Buffalo for the summer and move to the beach. Andrea and I would always joke around about how fun it would be to marry someone from the beach and how convenient it would be because summers are spent Crystal Beach and sometimes it's hard to convince people otherwise. We would talk about getting to raise kids in the town we grew up summering in around the people that we've spent our entire life with and what a dream it would be to do this for the rest of our lives. Andrea, your dream is coming true today. You get to marry your person and raise your family in our magical place. My brother Connor, who's sitting right over there, has been best friends with Mike and Joe since we were young. So the Braungart Cottage was the place to meet up for everyone. At first, Connor wouldn't let me hang out with his friends because they were too cool for us. But as time went on, we all became a friend group. And then all of a sudden, Mike and Andrea happened. From the moment they started dating, I knew this would be Andrea's forever person. The love these two share is something out of a storybook. Mike. Growing up with you, it felt like I had a third brother, and you too, Joe, a fourth. We were all so close, and I was so happy when you started dating Andrea. When thinking about a piece of advice to give you, to be honest with you, I really couldn't come up with anything. Mike, you know our girl more than anyone here. I've seen the love you have for every part of her life, so I know she is in good hands. So, I guess if I had to come up with something, it would be to never forget how special the girl is who's sitting right next to you. She will be your number one cheerleader on all of your highs and all of your lows. I know this firsthand. She will be your go-to person to guide you through all of your chapters together. I can't wait to see you two grow together and see what amazing things come in the future. I love you both so much.
Yeah. It's such an honor to be up here to celebrate these two. I love them more than anything, and it's not many people can say just how amazing and how beautiful and smart and ambitious and courageous of a sister that they have. And guys, Andrea can say that. And now Mikey can too! Woo! No, I'm kidding. I love you both so much. The second that you guys started dating, it felt like the pieces just fell into place. The puzzles, just everything happened the right way, the way it was supposed to happen. And truly, I love you both so much. Mikey and I, we already fight like siblings, so it's just gonna work out perfect. We knew this. I can't wait to come over and just hang out for Bills games on Sundays, you know, Monday night dinners. I can't wait to go stand in front of the fridge and just be looking and Mikey say, Jules, hurry up. You know, it's gonna be great. It's gonna be awesome, because it already is. Right? He hates it. I truly love you both so, so much. You guys are the perfect, perfect pair. I mean, look at how many people you have here today that love you all so much. It's just, we are so blessed. So, amazing round of applause to this amazing couple. I love you more than life. Let's party. One more thing. I cannot wait to be the fun Aunt Jules. Cheers.
To everybody out here tonight, there's a lot of you, and it really shows how truly blessed we are to have family and friends like this. Thank you for coming in. I know it was from near, far, from across the country, from close by, from other countries. There you go. Thank you for being here from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you very much. Another thank you, big thank you, Mom, Dad, and my new mom and dad. We wouldn't be where we are without you. This wouldn't happen without you. So please, everybody, round of applause for Mom and Dad. We love you. One more thank you to my groomsmen, best guys in the world right here. Bridesmaids, best ladies in the world right here. And Joe, you said it, my best friend right here. Thank you for everything. Thanks for always being there for me.
Thank you.
Even though you piss me off most days, you know, I still love you. So thank you all for coming. Let's get this party started. Cheers.
Thank you all for being here. And on behalf of our new McDonald family and the Gator family, we want to welcome all of you. And we're so proud and so happy that you're here. Being the father to Bride, I couldn't imagine being any prouder. To my beautiful baby girl, my Andrea. And when we say beautiful, we mean inside and out. You are just an amazing girl, and you are the beautiful, most beautiful bride in the world, and your mother and I are just so proud and happy that we could share this with you. And Michael, who's captured my daughter's heart and her mother's, you know, nothing can prepare you to give your daughter away, but if I had to choose, I'd choose you every time. So there you go. Love each other and respect each other every day, and you'll be happy. It's as simple and as difficult as that. And they say when children find true love, parents find true joy, and it's true. So we're so happy. So everybody, raise a glass. Let's have a toast to many McDago babies. To Mr. and Mrs. Michael McDonald.
Quiet our hearts and ask God to bless our evening in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good and gracious God, the source of love, the source of life, the source of family, giver of friends. We celebrate all of those tonight. As we look at Mike and Andrea and we toast them and we salute them and we root for them and we support and love them. Bless the meal that we're about to share, always helping us to be mindful of those who go without. May we contribute to the needy. May we celebrate, Lord, with great gratitude to you who give us possibilities like this because of love, especially the love of this man and woman, now husband and wife, now and forever. Amen. Spirit, amen.
I see thee is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love, is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love. Is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can't make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Love was made for me and you. Love was made for me and you.
Understand me when everything I do is wrong. You give me hope and consolation. You give me strength to carry on. You smile, the world is brighter. You touch my hand and I'm a king. Your kiss to me is worth a fortune. Your love for me is everything. I guess I'll never.
love this man. God bless the USA.
That's all the song, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Thank you.